Chapter 6, Health, Fitness, and Well-being. Topic 6.3. We will discuss about somatotypes. Our learning objective for this topic is to understand what is somatotypes, and the second one is we be able to identify types of somatotypes. Okay, what is somatotypes? It is a method of classifying body types. There is a three somatotypes. Number one, ectomorph. Number two, mesomorph. Number three, endomorph. Now I will explain the criteria of this body type. For endomorph person, they have wide hips and narrow shoulders. They have a lot of fat on the body, a lot of fat on the upper arms and thighs, and quite slim wrists and ankles. For mesomorph person, they have broad shoulders and narrow hips, a large head, a muscular body, very strong forearms and thighs, and very little body fat. The last one for ectomorph person, they have a narrow shoulders and hips, a thin face and high forehead, a thin narrow chest and abdomen, thin legs and arms, and very little muscles or body fat. And now, which sport should involve based on body type? Okay, the person will be involved in sport, they need to check what type of their body, and then they can choose their sport to involve. For example, marathon and gymnastics. So which body type of persons can involve into the sport? Of course, ectomorph, because they have a lean body, less of fat. Okay, for swimming and football, which body type of the person can involve into the sport? Swimming and football. Why? Because they have a very good muscular endurance, they have a muscular strength, and then not really high of fat and very less. For endomorph persons, they can involve in sport such as rugby and weightlifting. Why? Because they have a lot of fat and very strong muscles, and they need this strength because they need to lift or challenge themselves by doing something heavy or heavy load. Thank you.